All right, our next person is Nathan Cruz. Consequences of uranium mining on the Navajo Nation. Uranium-induced cell death in skin. His program is the Master of Science in Biology, and his faculty advisor is Dr. Robert Keller.
Many of us give little thought about the contents and purity of our drinking water. To Native Americans living on the reservation, heavy metal presence, like uranium, in local water is a daily concern. Uranium is a known heavy metal toxin used in many military and industrial settings, with a large portion being mined on the reservation in the last 50 years. Although mining has stopped, consequences of the extraction process linger. Uranium has leached into nearby water and soils as a result of the 500-plus abandoned mines. Attempts have been made to remove uranium from contaminated areas, but many of them still far exceed the EPA's maximum contamination limit. If water from these areas are ingested, complications can include poisoning of the kidney, decrease in bone volume, and a compromised immunity. Thus far, the majority of uranium health research has focused on exposure by ingestion. Little is actually known about the influence uranium has through alternative routes, such as exposure through external contact. This is a major concern because many residents may use the same water they ingest to bathe. If contact occurs through the skin, it has the potential to slow healing of pre-existing injuries and increase the risk of infection. And that's the focus of my research. My research aims to understand the harmful effects uranium has on the skin and its impact on healing. Based on current literature, I hypothesize that uranium will delay healing by inducing cell death through compromising DNA and altering normal cellular metabolism. To study this phenomenon, I grow human skin cells, expose them to relevant levels of uranium, then run tests that flag for any decrease in cell health. Thus far, my research has shown uranium to have a negative effect on human skin cells. In a 24-hour exposure experiment, I observed a significant decrease in cell number and metabolic rate in the presence of uranium. This can imply cells are dying due to exposure. In the next year, I'll be quantifying cell death proteins and DNA integrity to further explain this observation. These data will illustrate the major health complications that can occur in just a day's worth of exposure. My work will also utilize modern applied statistics to evaluate the degree of risk Navajo Nation residents are at when coming into external contact with uranium. Aspects of the current study sets the stage for possible medical intervention for residents and sheds light on an unknown health epidemic occurring in our very backyard. Thank you.